Hundreds in China has now reached the United States.
Washington, D.C. now has its reported first presumptive case, and New York's governor has declared a state of emergency.
At least four states, including Oregon and Ohio, have now ordered all schools closed.
For weeks, we've been told by health authorities, healthy people don't need these. Now, globally,
2 days ago, we were at nationals.
Okay, what's going to happen to spring umbrella?
What about our end of season party?
What about next season?
How will we practice on what we need? How will we compete?
What about NBA though?
No one will be able to see each other again.
I don't know.
We're back.
Let's do this.
Last year it was difficult because I feel like the kids didn't have enough time to actually like bond with each other. Even they were able to see each other through a camera, it's not the same as having a emotional and physical connection when you're able to see someone in person.
This team thrives on being very close. Not having that last year, I think, was definitely challenging for a lot of us, because not only did we have remote practice, but we also had remote school, so we weren't going out, we were just at home by ourselves.
In the last 2 years, I think the thing that I've noticed the most is I feel like they're gotten a lot closer, even through the pandemic, which is like crazy. With just having that experience, I think that you're seeing the team really appreciating the time to be able to be together and practice together. And so what we thought would be a bit of a challenge to get like them used to being back in person actually really wasn't.
Once we met up back like in April, kind of felt like no time had passed, even though we had two rookies, but I guess we did kind of bond with them over Google Meet, but it just felt like no time had passed.
And you know, in the last 2 years, it is almost a completely new team. You know, that was a big senior class that graduated. A lot more rookies than there are, you know, veterans returning.
Obviously, it was really sad to see the seniors go because it was like 10 seniors at the time. But the rookies that came in, like, we instantly all clicked, and this team just has so much chemistry. Like, we're all close.
A really good thing about this team is that we all do mesh so well together that it translates so well when we work together. And we all, like, can bounce ideas off each other and kind of, like, play with things. Getting to, like, dance with people, because since we all came from our middle school team, I think getting to dance together again is really fun.
You know, sometimes we go out at nights after practices, either working on our choreo or just hanging out, and I think it's been really great experience forming those relationships.
I think that this team is a super welcoming environment, and it's just something I look forward to, and how everyone is friends with each other.
We practice every single day, practically 5 days a week, and at like 6:30 in the morning. So I feel like we've grown like as a dance team, but also like as different people.
Of course, there are other teams that don't like other people on their team or their coaches.
But here, it's everyone is super tight, it's so close. The coaches are some of the best people ever. They're not just nice, they're not just kind. They are amazing humans.
They make it easy, I think they just get along.
So much of this organization is also student run and student led. That challenges us to not only communicate but also practice as a team of kids, not adults telling us what to do, but as a team of kids who are willing to work hard for something and accomplish something great.
Yeah, I think another thing that really sets us apart, and something that I am like personally very proud of for our team, is like we get awards for choreography, but we also get awards for like showmanship.
So other teams that are going to Florida that we compete against, some of them pay to have other choreographers make their routines for them.
Our team does make our own choreo. An aspect of that is that we show like who we are and our routine is a representation of all of our personalities, all of our style, and like everything like that. So I feel like that gives us also a little bit of an edge, because instead of doing someone else, you have to learn their style, you have to learn their choreo. You make it by yourself, you make it with your team, you make it with your coaches, like these people that you're close and that you're like your second family with.
This year's routine, it was a lot more intricate with choreo and much more stamina based.
We did have less tricks and we focused more on choreography and technique and less about kind of putting in things that the judges would appreciate more, like a team handspring or just like tricks every couple seconds. Like we focused more on like what we're good at.
This routine felt very smooth and just like comfortable and fun to watch, like beginning to end. And 2020's routine, although it was really exciting because it was so athletic in so many ways, as a coach, you kind of feel like you're holding your breath almost the entire time for them because you really want them to get through it. But this year, it didn't feel like that. This year, it felt like I could breathe through the routine. It was just fun and just like, it just worked really well.
This season has been very hectic. We started off our season going right into camp and then prepping for football performances and pep rally performances. So it was a lot for our team to prep for all these things, learn constant different dances and putting in formations.
This season, our competitions have went very well. We've won every single one and we got 2 grand champions. I think those local comps really helped us boost our confidence and it really helped us show off and also practice this routine, because this routine is definitely one of the hard, I think it is one of the hardest Dominion routines like that we've ever done.
There's definitely a lot of work to put in, but in the end, like coming up till nationals, it's definitely worth it. It's a lot of fun to work with all your friends, and because this whole team is like your family.
This year was definitely special because at the beginning of the year, we really didn't know that we were actually going to get a nationals.
We had a lot of difficulties trying to wonder even if we're able to go this year because of COVID and stuff like that, and like with the different guidelines that were constantly changing within the county. And it was just very much so up in the air if we're able to go. So I'm very happy that we're able to come this year.
I was really worried about when losing a season was losing progress that we had built up, especially our sophomore year, because we did a lot of endurance training. Like we did 15-minute runs and our conditioning was very heavy. But this year we really bounced back and I'm really proud of everybody for bouncing back the way that they did.
We are ready to compete at nationals without a doubt. I think this team, especially because we weren't gonna go for the longest time, we sort of lost motivation, but the second we found out that we were gonna go to nationals, nothing else mattered.
Going into nationals, I'm really nervous, especially like the thought that you won't like compete at finals. My first season on Dominion High School dance team has been really nice because I was on the Seneca Ridge dance team, and so I already knew everybody from middle school, but it was kind of nice to see everybody now that we've all like grown up.
In our sixth grade year, the Dominion dance team got first place, and I think ever since then, it really hit me. I was like, oh my gosh, if I do join in Dominion when I get into high school, then we're gonna get to that level.
We've gone first at all of our competitions, so I think that kind of sets like a high, like in a positive mindset for all of us. But I also think the coaches and all of our team members have helped us get ready for this. Like we've been drilling and cleaning over and over again.
Even though our team is made up of like half freshmen, you can't really tell that it's half freshmen. Like they dance at the level as if they were vets, and I think that's something that I'm very grateful for.
Yeah, although we did lose a whole season, I am really grateful that, especially as a senior, like my senior year, that we actually get to go. And shout out Dr. Brewer for pushing and helping us get there. I'm just grateful that we get to go one final time.
I get up, I get down, and I'm jumping around. And the rumpus and rock is so comfortable now. Been a hell of a ride, but I'm thinking it's it's time to grow. So I got an apartment across from the park, breaking rot in my fridge, still I'm not feeling right. Been a hell of a life, but I'm thinking it's time to go.
Here we go.
So put your best face on, everybody pretend you know this song. Everybody come hang, let's go out.
It kind of felt a little surreal just because, like, we didn't know if we would be here again. And shout out to Mrs. Cromai because she was the one who was, like, spearheaded for us being able to come back here. And it was just like a giant sigh of relief.
You got energy to breathe it in.
Here we go.
The first day, since our flight was later during the day, we didn't start practicing until a little later. I think it was around 9 or 10.
The first day we came at practice, we focused on just cleaning choreo. We did like a split between all the choreographers, so all five pieces, we kind of just really went in depth and like reviewed all the levels and the technique and the arm angles and stuff.
Okay, well, bring your hand back a little bit. Okay, reset. 7, 8, hold.
1, 2, 3, 4, and 5.
Can everybody count, please?
Well, watch your timing.
From now on, Mahika should never have to say, can everyone count again? Is everyone got it?
Counting will help you, I promise.
You're already low for this one, and you're just gonna jump. You're digging in into your heels, and you're pushing out. So you're here, 3, 4, 5, and 6. This is 5 and 6.
Be careful, a lot of you guys, when you do your first right hand, you go up like 45. You have to keep it horizontal here. So a lot of you are going like this.
Make sure you're low for this initial part, because sometimes what I see is 3 and 4, and then you guys come up 5, 6. But then like that gradual level change is lost.
1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, and 6, 7, and 8, and 1, 2.
Hold it. The first day, we definitely focused a lot on cleaning little details, like if it's a blade or if it's an open hand, where your head is facing, what angle your body is at, because NDA definitely tends to prefer cleaner routines, like clean and crisp lines, over intricate choreography.
Hey guys, listen up. There's only about 5 minutes for each piece, so if you see the choreographer working on something and it's also your part, can you also try it out? Just focus on what's being changed so that we don't have to say things multiple times, yeah?
6, 7, 8, 1, 2, hold it. One more time. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, cool.
So the only reason I say this is because in the routine, when we get super, super tired, and especially my piece, when the moves are super, super quick, it's super easy to shortcut them. So we really lose the leaning here. And also when we throw, we're throwing down here and our arms are not fully extended. So I just need to see 3, 4, we're holding this. The more you hold it, when you come here, the more you're gonna wanna actually lean back. 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2. All right, try that again. Just fix your pass so you don't run into anyone. But that looked really, really good. Try not to, when you're doing the pull, try not to go like place and pull. Try and make it more fluid, I guess. So it's not like that. It's more of your leg is going out, that's when you're sort of tensing and then bringing back in.
You ready? One, two, three, four, five, and six. Okay, do it again. Hello, Madrid, hello.
Okay, can you go to the end of the circle and you're about to go boom into this? I want to see that transition. But make sure you hit one, two, three, and four, you're leaning back, and then five, you're up. Five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, and four, five. Some of you guys are just like coming one, two, or three and four, and you're just kind of like posted. Actually like lean so you can jump into that, okay? One, two, three, and four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two. Look up, look up, look up.
Hey,
hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey. So good.
Good job, guys.
I really wanted to just like scream, but I was like, I gotta keep my noise level down. That was
guys,
so good.
Bring it in.
Bring it in.
So quiet.
I'm pumped.
Yeah, guys.
And you know, might have been a little frustrating today, if you ever felt frustrated, or you know, just a lot happening. But you know, here we are right now. We made it through our first practice. I think I'm feeling pretty good.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
let's bring it in. Ooh, yes. Titans on three, family on six. One, two, three,
yes.
Five, four, five, six.
Family!
I believed in God back in 09. So for prelims, breakfast was at, I scheduled it for 7, but the girls had hair and it takes a long time. It's 2 double braids and not very many of the girls know how to do it. So I believe they were up by like 6, braiding by 6:30 while also eating breakfast.
For me personally, waking up on prelims day, it was a mixture of both nerves and excitement. I was obviously, prelims is a very nerve-wracking experience because it is like a make or break for your nationals like routine. But I think that I was also really excited because I felt so confident about this routine, and I think we were all really excited to get to put it on stage and show what we'd been working for about 4 months on.
I felt kind of nervous, but also ready, but also very sore.
And for practice leading up to prelims, we just focused on running through little details of our routine.
One, two and three and a four and five, six, seven and eight and one, two, three, four.
Think about your movements and how you're hitting them. Don't just rush through it. Which way are you facing for 1, 2, 3, 4?
45.
Thank you. Make sure you're facing the 45s. One more time.
7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
When you're doing the dive show, make sure you're looking at the audience.
One thing that we wanted to do was clean up levels. Getting low is one of the biggest critiques that a judge can give you. And if you don't get low, it's very, very evident.
5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3.
3, is this 4 and then starts on 5? Or is it 4, 5? And 6.
4 and starts on 5 and.
Okay.
2, 3, 4 and 5 and 6 and 7 and 8 and. Thank you. That was good.
Okay, guys, listen up. So you step out 45, correct? So I want you to take that first step straight. Make sure your leg is straight. So then you just sit like that then, right? So can I see it super slow with counts? 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4.
I see you guys like reaching way too high. If you go too high, it makes the move look a little different. You gotta open it up, like widen it out.
1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4.
me, you get some money.
Keep going, all the way to one end.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven minutes to cover all the tricks that we have. All right, so whatever we don't get through on the first mat, we will let it continue on the second.
I don't know if we're going to get up to this or not, but like this is our chance to like start showing off what we work so hard on. It's our time to like start intimidating our teams.
Get nerdy, I know.
Remember, you're going after, boom, you're coming around and then down, yeah? All right, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and one. That was better. Make sure you're not late for two. Some of you guys were like down here and then you kind of already stepped and then you brought your hand up. Boom, you're down here. It should start from here. Boom, as you're coming up, bring it up. Make sure you guys are snapping and you're looking straight up.
1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
I don't even mind, this is so dumb.
I definitely felt it the next day on the practice floor, which is when we go practice before we compete and we go see other teams, and seeing other teams really makes it all feel real.
Prelims came and then that's when I realized like, wow, this is actually happening.
We did not take all this first place, right? We're going out there, we have something to prove. You got a chip on your shoulder, you're gonna play that person, you're gonna be sassy, you're gonna be angry, you're gonna be that person out there, help your teammates. Dance for the person,
talk to each other,
yeah? Use your vocal cues, okay?
Enjoy.
Anything that you want to do, this is the time.
Right now,
yeah.
I was beyond proud. Just being able to see all the hard work that they've put in this year, especially the officers, because they've been putting in double the amount, I feel like personally, just double the amount of work than we have in previous years.
I believe that though they gave a really strong prelim performance, knowing how the team was feeling because we were backstage, a great number of them were saying they weren't even nervous and they felt really relaxed, but I could feel the nerves, especially from some of our rookies, because they've just never done this before and it's a big crowd and I knew they had it in them. So I don't worry so much on the prelim performance.
When we got our score, we were sitting waiting in the ballroom. We were a little bit shocked.
I was a little confused because I didn't think we were going to score as low as we did. But then once all the other scores came out and a lot of teams were in like 82, 83, then I felt a little bit better.
I could feel the energy that from that, that our kids were ready to fight for it.
The judge's comments after prelims was mostly about our way of executing the moves, especially our authenticity. And a lot of them said that we looked like we were rushing and we didn't take our time.
We all knew that there was things we could do better and we could work on, but I think that we were all really excited to get the opportunity to do better.
But don't worry about that, that's just me and Devin saying it. We're gonna just leave it.
If we did it again, this would be worse. Because I saw the warning, but it also said deduction, but I could have just read it wrong.
It not tells you how much of a deduction it would be.
It says one, but I think it just said
1.5.
Like,
well, number of currents is one, number of warnings one, but the score didn't get affected.
Basically, Katya had a question about what the judge meant by making the transitions more interesting. Basically, I think when you guys start to move a lot, when you kind of sort of just forget to hit the choreo like you usually do. So even if you're moving from column 1 to 3, your choreo still needs to be attacked, and it still needs to be hit like you're just staying in place.
Also, I think it does have to do a little bit with the transition into We Run This. Sometimes it tends to be a little bit like the effect tends to be missed, and it looks like you guys are just bucket running into your spots, which just takes away like the purpose of the transition. It wasn't meant to be easier for you guys to get to your spots.
Think about a lot of the teams that we placed over that had a team hit spring or a team anything. That, you know, so don't think too much into that. There's teams that jump from place to place, and there's a lot of places, so.
And there's teams that fall.
Yeah, and then there's teams that fall. So we obviously don't want to be a team that's falling, but there's that possibility. I mean, I've seen the 4th to 1st. I've seen we saw 11th to 2nd. You know, like we've seen crazy things like that.
It's possible. 2 years ago, we got an 86 at prelims and an 89 at finals. Like you can go up. It's not hard to go up a couple points if you just put in the work to get it there. You can go up quite easily.
The attitude we should have right now is like, if you guys want to work hard and put in the time, we have an entire day tomorrow too. Like that's plenty of time. So. There's a lot we can do.
I came down here, right? I came down here with a purpose to watch you guys, right? And I came down here thinking, knowing you guys will get first place. That's in my mind. That's what I believe, right? So when you guys performed today, I know you guys were nervous and everything, but I was like, they'll be fine, right? So I want you guys to believe more in yourself, right? And this is gonna sound cheesy, but God, I can't remember what I'm about to say this. But repetition gives definition. So you guys been practicing this routine like constantly. Hours and hours, right? You know it. So relax, right? Don't stress it. Let it flow. Don't think about it. When you think about it, that's when you start to stutter, all right?
The night after prelims, we wanted to really change the circle because initially we had a pull, but because of the floor in our uniforms, it didn't really work. So we didn't want to risk doing that again on finals.
So we spent most of that night trying to figure out how to fix the circle in a way that would make it look like it was still having the effect that it was supposed to, while making it still be able to be done.
So I go from, say I go from one to here. So I'm gonna go, I usually face out, right? So I'm gonna go one, two, three, four. I don't know what I'm gonna do, but either way, we're gonna face in the circle.
Okay.
We're gonna come down here, and we're gonna have to rotate more than half. We're gonna have to rotate 3/4. So we're gonna rotate from here, we're gonna have to rotate all the way out here, and then droom.
Thanks, Kevin.
Wait, now, that may still cause the same issue of you getting stuck. What if we did this? What if we still kicked out? Okay. How was the spin, by the way?
I think it was fine.
The spin is fine, right?
We'll make it work, is what I'm saying.
I think that could roll.
Just try it. Okay, ready? I gotta go 5, 6, 7, 8 and roll in just one. As you roll in, slightly bend your knees. Just a little bit.
You have to condense as you're rolling. So you roll and condense at the same time. Or else you're not gonna be able to stay like this.
Okay, here we go, roll and condense, yolo it. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna go 5, 6, 7, 8, we'll try it. And 5, 6, 7, 8, roll.
Condense.
Mr. K, it's gonna work! It's gonna work! Okay. First one is, let's go, zoom. After going, zoom. And then freeze. Okay, I'm so excited for this. Ready?
Okay.
Okay, we all emphasize 5, please, because to make it work with the music the most, that's when the shoo happens, and that's when the like tensing needs to happen when we start turning. So emphasize 5. Okay. Here we go. Be there on 7. You're actually going to have to roll quick to be there on 7. Emphasize 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. No!
Let's just try it, let's just see.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold it. Hold it. Okay, and now hold it.
Okay.
And we're gonna hold 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hold it, hold it.
So currently right now we're just joining the circle because it needs the work. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1.
Yeah, that's better.
Come to the drop because there's no more spin. We have to make sure that when we fall down, we're all in the same position.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1.
Okay, okay, okay.
Wait, what?
You're so happy.
If we can roll back to get the part right before it and we can make it look good and make it all work, clean this now because then tomorrow we can feel good we got it out of the way. And it's just a matter of just running through it tomorrow.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3. You guys need to rotate a little bit more. I know it's hard on the grass.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Hey!
Nice, nice. Watch it.
The game is not too bad. Cause I might put it on your rules.
Double.
I don't get so deep till you sit down cheap like you won't go. No way.
Prelims was really good. I wish that could happen every year, honestly.
So having the full day to like actually relax, process everything, and put those changes in and have the kids have time to execute them properly was very helpful for everyone. Normally it's staying up really late, trying to make sure that we have everything done, and then kind of just like running off of fumes into finals and stuff like that.
I think the biggest benefit is look at it the night before, know what the judge had said, and kind of let that sink in overnight.
That morning, the day after prelims, we specifically worked on, we did do the circle again because we did have that space, but we also worked on just cleaning the pieces.
One. Reset, we're gonna do this three more times. Make sure when you're coming here, this is, you're pushing off with your right arm and leg on 5, 6, you're sort of here, and then make sure your left knee comes down first before your right knee comes down, and this comes down on 1, and remember you're squeezing it so it's not just flopping on 1, and it's meant to put down on this, on that count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. All right, just watch your knee, make sure it closes on 1 back there. Reset, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. We lost some of the, whenever we do it over and over again, when we roll in, it looks really, really good. I feel like when we add the spin and everything to it, I think that's when we start to forget like the textures and the technique we're supposed to have it. No point in the routine should you ever be like, okay, let's just get over this one move. Because then you start doing that in more places and it becomes apparent that you're not living in the moment and you're just rushing to get to the next thing that you might be able to do better. But you should be able to do this entire routine with the best of your ability at every single part.
7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 8, 8. Don't you love it, don't you love it, no, I ain't happy yet. But I'm way less sad.
Towards the afternoon, we wanted to focus on slowing down the movements, because especially in Make It Rain, which is Mr. A's piece, one of our biggest critiques was not rushing things, and I think that was the piece that everyone tend to rush their moves a lot.
And we focused more on making sure we were saving our energy and still making the movements clean and doing them to their full extent so that we didn't go through them too quickly.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. That was a lot better. One more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. All right, get back in there, do it one more time, please. Other groups, make sure you're watching so I don't have to clean the same thing.
You look so paranoid.
And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. Good. Can we try that one more time? I'm gonna go ahead and go through all the way through. 1, 2, 3, 4,
hit. And then can we emphasize three, please?
Alright, I very much loved Tina's facials. I loved Ashley's facials. Give me more. Try it again.
Come on, you're angry. Hey! Hey! Five, six, kick, 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 four, three, two, three.
All right, let's do the whole thing all the way up to hit, hit from the top row.
Hit!
Oh, snap and
pull! Hit, hit!
All right, guys, we're going to do hit, hit 10 times.
Oh, it's 10 times.
You ready?
Okay,
so after you do hit, hit, if there's not, if we're not critiquing anyone, just go right back to 3M. And 5, 6, 7, 8,
hit, hit!
Seven, eight.
Hit, hit.
So we're gonna do the transition into the X, but we're first gonna, guys, please pay attention. We're gonna do the transition into the X, but first we're gonna just do the movements. What you need to do is, we got a lot of things about finishing movements, and this is a, this specific transition is probably one where you're cutting your movements short. So make sure you are really using them. Make sure you're using your levels. You should be getting low for all of these. And for this, make sure you are actually like pushing forward your hips like a cat daddy. You're not just stepping with it. You're actually pushing forward.
1, 2, and 3.
I would have said forward. You want to think of the line from
here? I'm trying to feel like all the parts of my brain, all my muscles are just like.
7, 8, 1, 2, and 3, and 4.
Make sure you're 4 more 45 with your chest so that you're not facing the video side.
5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 5, 6, and. This half is still facing the audience, even though you're angling it down.
I promise everything will be alright, be okay. Your eyes are tight, but keep them open, cause you wouldn't want to miss a thing.
Come on, guys, I promise everything will be alright, be okay. Your eyes are tight, but keep them open, cause you wouldn't want.
That evening, we got a lot done. We made changes to the routine that I think ultimately like really did help the routine and make it look better.
Left, up, boom, okay. Yeah. Yeah, so for right now, everyone hit up, both your legs are straight, you're on your toe back here. Your back leg is on your toe when you hit.
3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, hit.
Look at the people and match your levels.
Everyone clap towards me. Like if you're in the top, like hit like a ah, ah. If you're in the middle, hit hey. If you're in low, but hit like ah, ah. Okay?
Are we all looking towards you? Yes. You're looking towards Devin. Nothing else.
We're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We're starting from 5 and 6. Do it good so we can go eat, yeah? Wow, I like it. Yeah.
The evening before finals, that was probably our most intense practice, and we kind of just combined everything that we were drilling before, like drilling the changes. We made a change in the last piece, which is two-step, which was another visual part. And we were just drilling changes, cleaning up things that we did the day before, and just trying to really take the judges' critiques and put them into our routine.
One full out of just whatever we just cleaned, so up until 5 and. Do it from the very beginning. So very beginning up until 5 and. The second time, we're just going to do all of bring 'em out full out, yeah? That was really good. Okay, now we're gonna do the whole piece, pull out.
Can we like actually like be like all the way
down? Yeah, so like 90s.
That's like a detail ever. That's a detail everyone should know.
All right, I want to see Make It Rain fall out real quick, and then I'm going to spot things, okay? 3, E, and 4, E, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You're pointing with your elbows. Aiden, bring your fist in. Aiden.
Boxer.
It's just a little bit higher. All right, drop it. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2. Don't rush, don't rush!
1, 2, 3, back!
Reset, I love their energy, but make sure that you guys aren't forcing your energy into every single movement because it's not needed in every single movement. You have time where you have the pockets where you can just let the movement breathe. So let it breathe and let yourself breathe so you don't die. Because let's be real, there's a lot more movements after this, okay?
I think we stayed up until 1 a.m.
We practiced, just what the judges said, like textures, not rushing your moves, levels, and also not being afraid to look up. I mean, like just looking at the judges and also showing them everything that we have, like, we were trying to like scare them or whatever in our vocal cues. That was a big thing, so yeah.
Okay, ready? 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, hit!
For the people on the sides, I know that you guys are like rushing to get to your spot, but like, just like, I don't know how to explain it, but just really, sure really run with 1, 2, so that when you do 3 and then hit 5, or 3, it's like you're actually getting up with everyone else, because right now it's like I'm running and then I just have to get up. But make sure that you're like just really speed with 1, 2.
Please actually do the movement if you're on the side.
Reset.
2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8.
Oh, that looks so good. So I think we should do the circle.
I'd love to.
Okay, we're gonna do the circle. Yeah. I don't know if we'll have this spot tomorrow. This could be the last time we ever do it with a circle before we go on.
Hey! 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, and hit! Actually, I pull my legs more back to you.
Yes! So much better! Which one will play that just in her ear?
So we're gonna start from 3, and then we're gonna hold, and then 1, 2, 3, and 4.
7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4,
yes, okay.
1, 2, 3, 4,
there you go, back. So good.
That energy was on another level, like that looks so good. Guys, if we perform like this, we can move up so high, you don't even know.
That was like
completely different performance from what you guys gave this week.
And you should be excited for that. Don't be nervous to do better. Be excited to do better.
You look like a completely different team by doing this, okay?
Used to keep it cool, used to be a fool, all about the bouncing master. Watch it on the news, what you gonna do? I could hear profession forget. Used to keep it cool.
A
by 6, starting here and breakfast at 6:30. We're out the doors practicing by 7, 8, and then back to finish hair and makeup. I felt like seeing them wake up and kind of feeling the energy, if I could feel that they were ready.
I was actually like weirdly calm. Just because we had the full day of being able to have practice and stuff like that, and everyone had time to just relax.
Honestly, I felt relieved and I felt excited.
I was calm, I was ready. I knew what we needed to do. I think the team knew what we needed to do to finally execute what we had changed.
I think practices right before finals, we mainly focused on looking ahead and making sure we were looking at the audience and not down, because we did struggle with that, with people, most of the team looking down during parts of the routine.
7 and 8 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 6, 7 and 8 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4.
One more time. You guys are bringing up this leg, but then this is kind of getting lost a little bit. Just, I know the transition is fast, but please make sure you're not cutting moves short. 5, 6, 7 and 8 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. You're starting with your elbows in front, you're bringing it out. And for people doing this, you're kind of like bringing your elbows upwards.
Circle again because we did have that grassy area, which was really nice.
5, 6, 7, 8. Hey!
Went over the changes and made sure that we each piece got amount of time to go over how to like really make sure you're moving, like going through the entire movements all like completely.
We're not due on practice floor until 152. So well, at, pushed it sorry, 1252. I mean, it's still more than an hour from now. Yeah. It's 11:24 now. So you have time. So I know from what I hear, last year was a little rush to the finish. Just feel like breathe. I feel like it felt a lot of
morning a little bit. Like, I can feel it from you guys, but you have time. You have a lot of time right now, right? I'd like to do a little bit of breathing with you before you jump back in. And then if you want, we can do a little bit more after. But if you guys are all, close your eyes. And if you can hear me, I'll try to speak really loudly. I know there's this little generator here, but just keep your eyes closed. You've gone through prelims. You got your nerves out. Most all of you at prelims said, I feel good. Like, I feel ready. And guess what? Now you feel even more ready because it's not your first time anymore. You've already done that. You've been there, done that, right? So take a deep, slow breath in through your nose. 1, 2, 3. And then just as slow out through your mouth. 1, 2, 3. And if it feels good to just go, get it out, do that. If it doesn't, whatever you're comfortable with. And what that is you're just breathing out whatever it is that does not serve you. You don't need it. Breathe it out. I know we're asking you guys for a 2-minute sprint with lifts. It's a lot. But you can do it. You've done it. This is easy, guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold. 1, 2. Out slow. 1, 2, 3. I want you guys to just feel, you know, you guys are loved. You've got your alumni here. They came to just love on you and cheer for you, scream for you. Like, they all were so excited to come and, like, surprise you guys. It's like, I don't know. You guys have such an incredible, like, Titan family. Everyone back home is cheering for you on the live stream. So, you know, I'm excited for you guys. And I love you guys. And I'm so happy to be here this year with you. I hope you feel my love because I will be screaming my butt off on the side. But you can open your eyes in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Are you feeling set? Way up, way up we go. Oh, yeah.
Oh. This is Dominion High School.
Let's go, guys!
You won't be with the king, what is you gon' do? We show up on the scene with two guns true. But you and your friend to play a little 2-on-2. It's gonna be standing in the front yard yelling, bring them out, bring them out. On the last day yelling, bring them out, bring them out. In the front yard yelling, bring them out.
Bang, bang, that's what I'll be screaming. Bang, bang, that's what I'll never be blaming. Man, it's bang, throwing cash like a bank. Then I pop me some champagne, so the yeah, I lay. Money in a bank.
Yeah, come to me and get some money. So, if I hit it one time, I'ma put it up. If I hit it two times, then I like her. If I check three times, I'ma wipe her. It ain't safe for the black or the white girls.
Yeah. Let me switch up the game.
Feeling my voice is going gone, but like afterwards, I felt nothing but happiness and overcome with tears and just happy for them because they gave a dope performance and they killed everything and left everything left on that they had on the floor.
I almost got really emotional because that was my last NDA competition, and I couldn't have asked for much more from the team. We really put 150% into everything. Like, I felt the energy throughout that routine, like, nobody really dropped.
I'm so excited and proud of them. I mean, just like being fourth place at prelims, that can really mess with a team's psyche. I knew that performance that they delivered at finals was even better than the send-off that I was so excited about. I mean, you saw, I was like in tears. It was flawless to me.
Yeah.
One day, maybe someday, I'll be so out of touch. I'll become a trumpet or a drum set in a sad orchestra. One day, maybe someday, in a world speeding up, it's getting hard, so very hard to keep up. One day, maybe someday, I'll be so out of touch. I'll become a or a in a sad orchestra. One day I won't know what to write, and I can't be 18 my whole life. But I'll try and I'll try and I'll try. But I'm not dead yet, so I guess I'll be
score-wise, we were definitely going to go up. I don't think I could have ever known how much, because we had never risen that many points before. But wow, I mean, this team wowed us.
It was definitely surreal. It means a lot to finally have everything come together and have everything work out and finally get what you've been working for.
And I'm so happy that I am able to create these memories with the kids.
Every year my seniors are, they're so near and dear to me, because you get to, most of them you do get as freshmen. And you get to know them through the years, and they essentially grow the most, like within those 4 years.
It still hasn't hit me yet that this is their last performance or at nationals and stuff like that. Like, I've known them for so long, and I've seen them grow from the little goobers that they are to the amazingly strong and talented young women and men that they are now. It's a little surreal to me, but I'm so happy to have been part of their dance journey, and I wish them nothing but the absolute best. And I know they have amazing things ahead of them in their journey in life, and hopefully they continue dancing, because they are some dope dancers.
I feel robbed of the last almost 2 years for me, because I was pregnant and unable to be there, you know, as much as I wanted to. And so I think that's one of the hardest things for me, especially the seniors last year and this year, is I didn't get to spend as much time soaking them in, you know, as much as I would love to.
I think all the seniors are so amazing in their own ways. It's just, I'm gonna miss them so much.
Coral, I became so close with her this year. We have a lot of jokes. She's just like an older sister, and like I always look up to her. And she's like really funny, like unintentionally very funny.
Mahika is my base for my handstand, and we've all been through a lot together. We got really, really close this year, and she is just like, she's such an amazing leader, and she's such a good influence on the entire team. And I think that she really is like the epitome of what the dance team like means.
Aiden, he's like your hype man. He's one of the hype men on the team. Like, he just boosts your confidence a lot, and he's definitely someone that's very meticulous about certain things, but it helps so much. And he's just doing it because he loves the team and everything, and he's definitely a friend that you need in your life. And then lastly, Devin, he's your second hype man. He's always there for you. He legit hypes up like everyone on the team. It makes you feel good. And you know, it's very obvious that he cares about the team a lot.
Aiden, Devin, Mahika, Coral, I mean, I love them so much, and I'm gonna miss them so much. It'll be really tough to say, you know, see you later this year. Because I always tell them, if you don't come back, I'm gonna be angry with you.
For me, after high school, I am going to Penn State, Pennsylvania. And over there, I'm gonna be majoring in business as well. I hope to find a dance club there as well. I have a friend over there that's told me that there's like clubs and teams, so I really hope I can like join that kind of team as well.
I'm going to be going to either the University of Nevada, Las Vegas, or the University of Memphis, and I hope to try out for both of their hip-hop teams. I'm going to study kinesiology, and I will probably minor in exercise science.
After I graduate, I'm still deciding where I want to go. It's between Tech, George Mason, and then University of South Florida. But I'm hoping that I can still compete in hip-hop at a collegiate level, if there's a team at the school, or if not at the school, somewhere like in the local area.
After high school, I'm still deciding on where I want to go to college. It might be Virginia Tech, South Carolina, or UVA. I haven't decided yet, but I probably won't do dance this level of intensity, but I sure hope I can continue to make choreography and do it recreationally with the club, or do some sort of coalescence kind of stuff.
Giving back to the people that came before you and kind of shaped what you came into. Going back all the way to like when I was in middle school, people like Jenny and Clarence and even like Jonathan and Heiko, Betza, all those people have shaped how this team runs. Something that I wish my impact would leave is that the people that are on the team now get that same thing from me.
Dancey night is just a night where everyone on the team gets dressed up and we got to dinner and everything. 2 years ago, we did fancy night the day we came to Florida. This year we did it after finals, so it was a really good night to just relax and everything.
I think one thing that I will definitely take from this competition is hard work. That is one of the fundamental aspects of this team is hard work, and it's a lot of blood, sweat, and tears. It's a lot of emotion.
This season and like this competition, like nationals in general, is just like the feeling of happiness. I think like this season especially, I was just so happy all around, and like coming into dance practices, competing with the team, and coming to nationals all as one is just one of the best parts of my junior year. It's been very hard in school, but like coming to dance and just seeing everyone is like one of the things that makes me the most happy. So I think I'm gonna miss that feeling from this year.
I think that the thing I'll take away the most is knowing how much these kids are giving us. You know, we give a lot to them, but I couldn't be more thankful of how much they're giving to us. This is their time, their energy, their love. And time, their time is a currency that you will never get back, none of us. It's such a finite, you know, resource. And the fact that they are willing to spend all of that as much as they do with us is like something that I will always keep with me in my heart, because, I mean, it's by choice, right?
We've always wanted to try to build a community around this dance team, a community that feels like family. I think that the feedback from you guys is that you guys do feel like this is your second family and this is your home. And so we honestly couldn't be prouder, and we've been doing this for so long not because it's easy and not because of the awards. We do it because of the feeling that you guys give us. Every time you hit that floor, I get super emotional. She gets emotional. I mean, everybody around you, gets emotional because you guys just have a unique energy about you guys, and every year the team is different. Every year the team is something special. You guys are, an example of that. You guys are nothing, no different. This is a very special team. We've been saying this since the beginning of the year. Like, just feels different, guys. Like, this feels really good, and we're so proud of you and like your parents. We could not have done this without obviously you or your parents. You guys thank us, but you guys thank us all the time, but really never forget to thank your parents for the years of support they've put behind you. It's not just like the time coming to cheer for you, it's supporting the thing that you love, that you find so important in your life. And so, keep doing that. Keep finding important things. And, obviously my seniors, and I can't talk about my seniors ever because then I get so sad, but I know you guys are gonna move on from here and choose really amazing things, and I know that you guys have parents that are gonna support that every time, and you guys are so lucky.
I don't know, I look back at this season and
you do have a voice you like.
No, I don't. Look, it's going away. I look back at the season and it's just amazing to see like how this team has literally come together. Not even, I mean, the season may have seemed like a long time, but it really was, it just flew by. And we had a year that should have been a rebuilder year, but every time I look at this team perform, I mean, I feel like it's a very strong veteran team. It's just unbelievable how much of yourself you give into this team when you perform. And I couldn't be any more proud of you guys and for everything that you have given to us. Honestly, like, second place in the nation, like, I mean, you guys.
At home, 'cause I wanna move out, I don't wanna move on.
Hello.
Got my breasts off today.
Ew.
Not too close.
So hey, what's up? It's your boy. We're out here. It looks like I'm blonde. Just a
week
like
before
blonde.
Next.
Yeah, kind of.
Bro,
but I see your hand.
Like all the way over my head.
Cam.
Oh no.
Go ahead, Devin. Do your thing. Oh, oh, oh.
Oh, conditioning right here. Oh, can you hear me if I do some squats?
You stopped us for this?
Yeah.
Sir, I want my bags. I feel like every time I turn my head, he's there.
This is a long walk.
This is like that hallway. What's that movie? When that guy like kills his kid?
Oh my god.
Oh, damn it.
Can I say something? Lift my rider ponytail, bro. You're almost saying it in your neck. That's so weird.
Do it again.
My gloves are really, really old, so they're probably gonna retire with me because that's what they look like right now.
Oh my god.
So.
We lost the dance team, but everything is fine. Do you know where they are?
They disappear too.
I got this.
So that's why I'm like really.
Okay.
Getting food. Getting food. Hashtag food.
Hashtag anyways. I'm a little hangry.
Hashtag we're all
that's
starving.
So true.
Hashtag
you guys
old goldfish.
Why is this always a thing? I don't understand. Claire, explain.
The very first one is it goes zoom, zoom, and then freeze. Okay, I'm so excited for this. Ready?
See how you slow down the roll? They just literally went boom. So you can't, we can't do that. Yeah, it has to be a smooth landing. Like, it has to end like. like softly, essentially. So if we do it this way, it would have to end softly.
Every time!
Bad words, no, no.
It's the wrong mix.
What the freak?
From the beginning.
You guys, a fairy.
Wait, the grasshopper's away.
Wait, I don't want anyone to watch my feet on YouTube.
Blur it out.
Can't have that for free, Kevin. Three, open your head.
Can I give you a big smile?
Smile. No, that's not good enough. Put your head down.
Unacceptable.
No, unacceptable. One, two, three. Open your eyes. Unacceptable. Put your head down. Put your head down. Unacceptable. One, two, three. Open your eyes.
I love the light tremble.
What should we say? Should we just do a boomerang? Yeah. I'm doing a boomerang. This is
Mom,
important.
Just take the picture already.
I never post on my Instagram. Do something funny.
Okay, let's go.
Shut up. Go in there.
Take the picture. Come on over to Mrs. K, please.
Mr. A, tell us about the open hand.
The what?
The open hand.
This is open hand? Not open hand? Open hand. Not open hand.
Backing up yesterday.
I know, he was like rookies.
Well, because you did it here.
Because, yeah, I did do it here. But this is it was also like late at night and like.
No, it was like the middle of the day.
This is an open hand. I swear to God, if I have to tell y'all open hand again, open hand is expanding all of your fingers. This is not an open hand. This is a lazy hand.
Oh, it was middle of the day?
Yeah, it was during the day.
I don't remember half the things I say during the
day,
so.
Oh my gosh, oh.
Are you emotional right now?
Let's go. Okay, here we go.
Settle down.
Shivering, you're trembling. It's warm in here, so come back in. Cause I wanna move out, I don't wanna move on.